Yo, what's up everybody? Fortitron here, and today I got something special to share with you guys. You all bought me a computer. Let's get into it. Yeah, this is crazy. So back in February, kind of right before Elden Ring was kicking off, a lot of my videos just were popping off. So I don't know, I had a few of them, the classes explained video, the Elden Ring looks bad video. A bunch of those videos were just really popping off and my channel was exploding. And I had an incredible month in February, and that's thanks to a lot of you. And now that the Elden Ring kind of hype's kind of fading down as people are playing the game now, I started to reflect on that. And something cool arrived today that I purchased with the money that I received from YouTube. So from people watching my channel, subscribing, I bought a gaming PC, which is insane. I haven't owned a PC in I don't know how long. The reason why I purchased one is I have a PS5, I have an Xbox Series S. That was getting me by for a while there. But now that I kind of want to be able to play all the Souls games, I want to do meme runs. I want to do a bunch of cool stuff. And you just can't do that on console. You need cheat engine in a lot of the stuff, the tools that are available on PC that are just not available on console. And it's just a huge pain, especially if you want to flip between different updates of the game or different patches. It's either version 1.0 that comes on the disc or latest patch. That's it. You can't go in between. I decided to get a gaming PC. And I know what you're all wondering. You're like, well, graphics cards are crazy right now. Which gaming PC did you get? Are you building a PC? And the answer is no. I bought a pre-built PC because a really good deal came up. I saw it on IGN. I got a pre-built, and I know everyone's like, don't get a pre-built, they suck, blah, blah, blah. And I watched a ton of videos on them, and I was like, I don't care. I want one. It's going to be insulting what I use this thing for because it's not going to be my main computer. I'm still going to be using my Mac, which I have is my main machine. It's what I do all my editing on. That's not going to change. This is purely just for gaming on. I'm going to treat this like a console, basically. So what did I get? Dude, I got a Dell. So today I'm going to be unboxing this with you and we're just going to unpack it. Let's get into it. Okay, so I'm gonna try and do this as cool as I possibly can. I don't really do unboxings, but I wanted to make this special. So you're wondering why. Okay, so why would you get a pre-built? And it's because PC parts are just insane right now with the chip shortage. People still can't even get PS5s. It's impossible to get a decent graphics card for a really good price. You have to pay scalpers, or you have to pay the insane overcharging. Which is going on right now. And I just wasn't into it. I was like, dude, I just don't want to do that. I've built PCs in the past. I've worked in tech for years. I know how to build a computer, but I priced it all out. And even with a friend who works in one of those PC part places, they were like, yo, graphics cards are messed up right now. I could get you a 1650 or a 1660 super and it would be $800. And it's I'm not paying $800 for a 1660 super. This is not happening. I saw that Dell was fleecing off a bunch of their gaming towers because the 12th gen Intel chips came out. And so they had a really good sale. And I was able to pick this one up for an insanely good price. And it probably would have been the same amount as if I built it myself, if all the prices were MSRP. And I actually got an RTX 3080 gaming computer. All right, let's open this thing up. Again, I'm not super awesome at unboxing, so I'm gonna be doing my best here. Let's just get this crappy outer box off. But I gotta tell you right now, this is a completely different experience than I'm used to. I got an unboxing knife. I started this YouTube channel about 2 years ago now, and I never would have thought that I would be at 5,000 subscribers almost with a million views. It has just been insanity. A mouse and a power cable, keyboard that it comes with. This is a lot of cardboard. But yeah, so pretty wild how my channel started out. 2020, it was peak Pandy. And I've been wanting to make a YouTube channel since 2014. I'm really sorry if the audio is bad because I'm moving away from the mic. So I've wanted to make a YouTube channel since 2014. And I just kept making excuses why I wasn't doing it. And then 2020 came along and I was finally all right, let's do this. As some of you may know, I started out doing how to stream on a Mac and that kind of stuff. That was cool for a bit. And Like, I like making those videos. I don't know, like, I kind of wanted to do more. It also got kind of tiring, like, having to, like, help people in the comments with their troubleshooting issues. And I was like, no, I'm not about that. So, somewhere along the line, I was like, I kept trying to chase, like, the next, like, how-to video. And, like, I wanted to be, like, super snappy with my editing. And then you'll see that in the mix there. And I just wasn't seeing results from that. It was like, if someone found a video that was helpful, they would just never come back to my channel. Because like, oh, he solved my problem. So there's no point to continue to watch more tutorials on how to do stuff. And I've always been really passionate about Souls games. So like, obviously, like I have like a ton of Souls tattoos. I was like, I just want to do gaming stuff. And I did that and it was slow to start. Like I was used to my videos doing a certain amount and then it was like going back to ground zero again. And that was kind of scary. But yeah, like it was nuts. It was just the right timing. And like I mentioned before, a couple of my videos popped off. That was like pure insanity. And it just made me realize, like, like you gotta do what you wanna do. And if you're gonna start a YouTube channel, like be prepared to make a video. Like if you're not prepared to make the exact same video and talk about the exact same thing 50 times after you upload a video, it's probably not the video that you should be uploading. If you're uploading content that you like, you just want to talk about once and then that's it, that's not really going to work for you, because how YouTube works now is that it rewards the content, not the channel. If something's a hot topic at the moment and you make a video on it and it's really popular, if you drastically change the topic or even change it a little for your very next video, it will do almost no views. But if you essentially put out almost the exact same video that was really popular, but you just like, you change your perspective on it or you just alter it a little bit, it'll do insane. And that's one of the things that I learned. Let's get this crazy looking thing out of here. I'm already like, what is going on? All right. Like I mentioned before, like I haven't owned a PC in 10 years, maybe longer. Probably longer. I've been a Mac user for quite some time. So this thing is hilarious looking. I can hear something loose already. Maybe that's why it was such a good deal. But look at how hilarious. This thing looks like an air purifier. So you're probably wondering what the specs are. So something like, it's nothing like insane, except for the graphics card. I think the graphics are just pretty awesome. So it's a 6-core i5 and it's got 16 gigs of RAM. It's got a 1 terabyte SSD and it's got an RTX 3080. And it's great. It's like all that stuff is like easily upgradable. So if I want more RAM, then I can just upgrade the RAM. And like I mentioned before, this is not my daily driver. It's going to be like, this is, I'm going to treat this like a console essentially. So it's like the airflow is so bad in these things. Like, why would you buy a Dell? Like, you should have just built your own. And it's like, dude, I'm not paying double for a graphics card. I got this because I got all of the components for the price that they're supposed to be. And yeah, it comes in a Dell box and it's like, who cares? It'll have a 1-year warranty. And like I mentioned before, I've watched all those videos where like people call me a neckbeard. These dudes are neckbeards and they're like taking it apart and they're like, look how trash these thermals are. Like, look how crappy like the fan placement is, or like there's no airflow, blah, 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 blah. And they'll just tear down this thing so hard. And then they'll replace the fans, they'll reapply the thermal paste, they'll do all this shit and it's improved the airflow like by 10%, and they get like an extra 2 to 3 frames per second out of their game. Like, it's so minimal. They also like all the bloatware that these things come with. Who cares? Uninstall the apps or just do a clean install of Windows. It has the Windows key probably in the box or printed on the side of the tower itself. So you just do a fresh install of Windows. Boom, you got no bloatware. Who cares? I just don't think it's that big of a deal. Plus, I, like I mentioned before, I worked in tech forever. I can easily get this thing to do what I'm gonna want to do with it, which is play From Software games, which max out at 60 frames per second. And I think only Elden Ring has the ability to go to like 4K, maybe Dark Souls 3 does too, and Sekiro, but like this graphics card is not gonna be utilized to its fullest. I want to play some Souls-like, so I knew that Timeneasia was only gonna be on PC, and it would be cool also if like some developers can hit me up and be like, yo, do you want to try out our Souls-like game? And before I'd have to be like, well, I only play on PlayStation 5 or Xbox Series S. And they're like, oh, well, this game's on PC, it's in Steam. And I'd be like, well, I can't play your game then. But now I can accept offers like that and I can play these games and review them and talk about them with all of you. And it's all thanks to you guys. And I just want to say thank you. And it's because of you I'm able to pay for this and have this. And I just didn't think that I would be in a place where I could be like, yeah, YouTube money paid for a gaming PC for me.
Meow.